answer, he carried home two?
No, three antelopes.
Three antelope at once.
This man's name was Shidusa.
And his wife's name was Shitu. One day, he came to her.
What? Just look at his muscles. I must be the strongest man in the world. From now on, just call me Master Man.
Hoo-ah! But Shitu said,
hey, quit your foolish bossing. No matter how strong you are, there will always be someone stronger. And watch out, somebody may meet you.
Next day! Shatu paid a visit to a neighboring village. On the walk home, she grew thirsty, but she stopped by a well.
She threw in the bucket.
Splash!
Then she pulled on the rope, but though she tug and heave,
hey.
She cannot lift the bucket.
Just then, a woman woke up her baby. Salam, Jatwa.
The two women pulled together, but still the bucket will not budge.
Maybe, you know what to do.
The baby quickly pulled out the bucket and filled her mother's calabash. Then she threw in the bucket and pulled it out once more for Shetu.
Oh my god, I don't believe it.
It's not so strange when your husband is Master Man.
When Shetu got home, she told Shidusa what had happened.
Oh my god.
Master Man?
Hoo-ah!
He can't go inside that. I'm Master Man.
Hoo-ah!
I'll have to teach that fellow a lesson.
Oh, husband, no. If the baby is so strong, think what the father, Master Man,
hoo-ah!
Must be like. You get yourself killed.
We'll see about that.
The next morning.
Hoo-ah!
Shidusa set out early and walked till he came to the well.
Then he threw in the bucket.
Splash!
Then he pulled on the rope, but though he tug and heave, he cannot lift the bucket.
Just then, the woman with the baby walked up.
Wait a minute. What do you think you're doing?
I'm getting water, of course.
Well, you can. The bucket will come up.
Maybe?
The woman will have contact with the baby. Pull out the bucket and
fill it with my
calabash.
What? How did she do that?
It's magic, magic, magic.
Oh, it's not so strange when your father's Master Man.
Hoo-ah! Shidusa gulped and thought about going home, but instead he thrust out his chest and said,
I want to meet his fellow so I can show him who's the real Master Man.
Hoo-ah!
I wouldn't do that. He devours men like you. But
if
you
talk to me.
So Shidusa followed the woman back to a compound. Inside the friend's yard was a gigantic fireplace, and inside it was a pile of human bones.
What's all this?
Well, you see, our hut is so small that my husband must come out here to eat his elephants.
Elephants?
Elephants?
Just then, they heard a great
roar!
It was so loud that Shidusa had to cover his ears.
And the ground began to shake. The Shidusa could hardly stand.
What was that?
That's Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
Oh no! You weren't fooling! I've got to get out of here!
Well, it's too late now, but they're behind you!
By the fans were last some large clay pots, each as tall as a man for storing grain. She helped him climb into one. Then sit the place.
Shidusa took a peek out. And there, coming into the compound, was Master Man! Carrying a dead elephant across his shoulders.
Papa!
Yes, my daughter?
Abba, did you have a good day?
Yes, I am. Papa! I forgot to bring my bow and arrows. I had to kill this elephant with my bare hands.
Hey, Shidusa, watch in terror. Master Man built a huge fire in the fireplace, roasted the elephant, and devoured every bit of it but the bone.
Suddenly he stopped, and he sniffed.
Wife, I smell a man!
There's no man here now. When passed by while you were gone, that must be my smell.
Too bad. You would have been tasty.
Then he rolled over on the ground, and before long the leaves trembled from his snort.
The woman hurried over to the pond and slid off the lid.
Quick, get away now while you still can.
Shedusa leaped up and bolted down the path.
But he hadn't gone too far when he heard a distant
roar
and felt the ground trembling beneath him.
Master Man! What's coming?
Shedusa ran till he came upon five farmers hoeing a field. One of them called,
"What's your hurry?
Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
He's after me!
Take it easy!
We won't let anyone hurt you!"
Just then, they heard a terrible
roar!
The farmers all grabbed their hoes and covered their ears.
What was that?
That was Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
Well then, you better keep running!
And the five farmers in back of the
Shedusa ran out till they met a few porters carrying bundles.
"What's your hurry, young man?"
"Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
He's after me!"
"Relax, no one can fight a smoke."
Just then, the ground quaked, and they all bounced into the air. The porters fell in a heap, all mixed up with their bundles.
What was that?
That was Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
Then, run for your life!
And the porters bolted from the path. Shedusa ran on until he rounded a bend.
Then he stopped short.
A dead end!
There, beside the path, sat a stranger. And there, beside the stranger, lay a huge pile of elephant bones.
"What is your hurry?"
Master Man!
Hoo-ah!
He's after me!
"You better not say so, cause I'm Master Man!"
Hoo-ah!
From behind Shedusa came another
bang!
And once again he bounced into the air.
The stranger caught him in one hand as Master Man ran up.
"Let me have him!"
"Come and get him if you can!"
Master Man laughed, but the stranger tossed Shedusa into a tree. Then the two strong men wrapped themselves around each other and wrestled across the ground.
Master Man!